subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates.
Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand how to represent negative numbers or signed binary numbers. So far in our previous videos where we have discussed about the binary number system, so far we have discussed only about positive numbers and their representations. So if you recap the previous videos, we never ever discussed about the representation of negative numbers. For example, in our previous based upon our previous discussion, we know how to represent the positive decimal numbers only, but we haven't seen how to represent the negative numbers. For example, if you are given with a decimal number 9 plus 9, how it can be represented in binary? It can be represented in binary as 1001. But what if you are given with minus 9? If you are given with 9 minus 9, how it will get represented in binary? So do you have any mechanism? Have you seen any method to represent minus 9 in our previous discussion? No. So in this class, we will try to understand how these negative numbers can be represented in binary. So before going into the discussion about how to represent the negative numbers, we will try to understand about the components of the computer. For example, if you want to buy a computer, what you will ask in the shop? In the shop, you will ask for, I want a computer with a processor of 64 bit or 32 bit. And you will ask for, I want a RAM of 6 GB or 8 GB or 16 GB. So in that way, you're going to give some specifications. So what those specification means? In the sense, if you are asking for a 64 bit processor, what does that mean? What does that mean is the data unit that needs to be stored or processed will get stored in the components of the computer will be of size 64 bits. What does that mean is, for example, if you want to store 1001 onto the computer, which is of size 64 bit, and what are the components of the computer? The components of the computer like arithmetic logic unit, resistors, next address bus, next is data bus. So these are the components, and these are the components where the data unit can be stored and it will get processed. So all these components of the computer are capable of processing or storing the data of size 64 bit. What does it mean is, if you want to store plus 9 onto the resistors, how the plus 9 will get stored is, so will it be of size 4 bits? So with this we can know that it is 9, but is it going to be stored in this way in the resistors? No, it is not going to be stored in this way. How it will get stored is, every data unit is of size 64 bits. It means after 1010 preceded. So it is preceded with 60 more zeros. So 1001 is preceded with 60 more zeros. A total of 64 bits is used to represent 9. In order to represent 9, we are using 64 bits. And in order to process this 9 in the arithmetic logic unit, there also it will get processed in the respect to this 64 bits. So this is how the components of the computers are designed. Okay. So in order to get a rough idea on the components of the computers, how the things will get stored and processed, so this is just a small view to have an understanding of how the data units, the data will get stored and processed on the computer. The clear description about these concepts has been already made in our computer organization course. So this entire, the dealing with the components of the computer, how the things will get processed and stored. So we had a clear understanding in our computer organization course. Now coming to this class, coming to this class, we will consider. So 64-bit resistor is a bit difficult to understand or a bit difficult to show on the board. So we will consider that our computer is 8-bit computer. Okay, which means our computer is a 8-bit computer which is having resistors. So all the resistors in the computers are of size 8-bit. So this is the visualization of the resistors. So this is the visualization. So every bit will have a compartment, will have a flip-flop. So don't go deeper into the concepts. So this is a resistor, and the data unit that is getting stored. So for example, if you want to store 9 onto this, the binary representation of 9 is 1001, and the preceding bits will get stored with 0. So this is how this we are going to have a visualization of a 8-bit computer, which means the resistors, arithmetic logic units, and the address buses and the databases are having a capacity of storing and processing 8 bits. So this is our assumption, and now we will try to understand how the negative numbers will get represented on this components. Okay, now ways to represent negative numbers or signed numbers is three different ways. They are sign magnitude number, ones complement method, and sign magnitude method. So this is a sign magnitude method, ones complement method, and twos complement method. There are three different ways in which a computer may use to represent negative numbers. A computer either may use sign magnitude method, or it may use ones complement method, or it may use twos complement. It is going to take any one of them, and it is going to represent the negative numbers by these methods. Most of the computers in the modern days, they are going to use twos complement method to represent negative numbers. For example, if we try to represent -9, if we try to represent -9 by using the nines complement method, how that happens? We will try to understand how the -9 will get represented by using the nines complement method. By using the sign magnitude method, if we try to represent a -9, how it will get represented? If the computer is using the sign magnitude method, in sign magnitude method, an additional bit called a sign bit is placed in front of the number. So what does that mean is, one additional bit, this is what we call it as sign bit, and this sign bit is used to represent whether the number is a negative number or a positive number, and the remaining bits are used to represent the magnitude of the number. The magnitude of the number is represented by the remaining bits, and here we are using 7 bits for magnitude and 1 bit for sign bit. How the negative numbers are represented? If the sign bit is 0, the number is positive. The number, the binary equivalent, that binary equivalent of 9 is shown in the magnitude, which means 000 1001. This is the binary representation of 9. If it is a negative number, if it is a positive number, it is represented, this sign bit is represented with 0. This is the magnitude, it shows that it is 9. In order to represent, this is the magnitude, and it is represented by these bits. In order to represent this sign bit, we are using one single bit, whether it is a positive number or a negative number. If the sign bit is representing with 0, means it is a positive number. If the number is negative number, if sign bit is 1, the number is negative number. For example, if you want to represent -9, this sign bit is represented with 1. This is a method which is called a sign magnitude method, This is the way in which we represent the minus numbers, negative numbers and positive numbers by using the sign magnitude method. Sign magnitude method is not used and it is not practical because if you use sign magnitude method, the hardware is going to be very high. We have to use extra hardware for subtraction. Okay, so that is the reason why the sign magnitude method is not used practically. So most of the computers uses either 1's complement or 2's complement method, and mostly 2's complement method is used. If the computer is using 1's or 2's complement method, how the numbers are represented, how the negative numbers are represented, which means if the computer is using 1's complement method to represent the negative numbers, how the negative numbers are represented, that we will try to understand. If the number is positive number, if the computer is using 1's complement method and if you try to store positive number, the magnitude is represented in its true binary form. The magnitude part is represented in its true binary form, which is same as this one, 000 1001. For example, if you want to store 9 plus 9 by using the 1's complement method, the magnitude of the number, if it is a positive number, the magnitude of the number is used as it is. Okay, and sign 0 is placed in front of the MSB. MSB means this is the most significant bit of the magnitude. In front of it, a 0 is used. In front of this most significant bit, a 0 is used. If the number is negative number, how it will get number represented? If the number is negative, the magnitude is represented in its 1's or 2's complement method, which means if the computer is using 1's complement method, then the number, so we have to find the 1's complement of this number, and that 1's complement of the number is stored here. Okay, so what is the 1's complement of this number? 0001001. In our previous videos, we have discussed all these concepts, how to find the 1's complement, 2's complement, all with respect to the positive numbers has been discussed, all the concepts has been discussed. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of the entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts, and the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Okay, now we have to find the 1's complement of this number. The 1's complement of this number is just complement every bit of the number. So this 1's complement of the number will get stored. So this is the negative number representation in 1's complement number, in 1's complement method. If the computer is using the 1's complement method, finding the 1's complement of the given number is the negative number representation of 9. So this represents minus 9. Okay, this is the negative number representation, which is 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 1 1 0, and a sign bit 1 is placed in front of the MSB, and a sign bit 1 is placed in front of the MSB, which means indirectly what it means is just find the 1's complement of each and every bit, and the sign bit is initially stored with 0. If it is a negative number, just find the 1's complement. If you do the 1's complement, the sign bit is going to be 1, because we are going to complement every bit. Okay, so this is how the 1's complement if the computer is using ones complement method, this is how the negative numbers are represented. What if the computer is using twos complement? If it is a positive number, same point. If it is a positive number, the magnitude is represented in its true binary form and a zero sign is placed in front of the MSB. So defaultly it is stored with zero, and this is stored with the true binary form. It is 0001001. If it is a negative number and it is using 2's complement, we have to find the 2's complement of its true binary form. What is the 2's complement of its true binary form? 1's complement plus 1. 1's complement plus 1, and it is 0101010000. Sorry, it is not the 2's complement. We have to find the 1's complement of this number. It is 1110111. So the 2's complement of this number is 111011. Okay, so it is 111011. This is the negative number representation, and a sign bit 1 is placed in front of the MSB. Okay, so this is how the negative numbers are represented on a computer if it is using any of these methods. If it is using sign magnitude method, it is if it is using a sign magnitude method, it is going to be shown in a different way. If it is using ones complement method, we have to find the ones complement of the given number, and the magnitude of the number is represented by the ones complement, which means if it is a 9, means the negative number representation of 9 is just find the ones complement. Finding the ones complement gives the negative number representation of the given number. Okay, so this is how the representation of the negative numbers can be done. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.